rewarding work. So this poem is called Dissection. Once, on the bus ride to school, the girl saw a man smash another man's head into the sidewalk. The city bus kept moving down Atlantic, past the diner where pies were stacked like beacons, beyond metal carts bulging with water bottles, bond businesses, billboards holding out impossible promises. Her backpack full of biology, English, history, Spanish, math. The bell would ring. The teachers pacing linoleum floors would mark her papers with ink. The day went on like this, except for in biology class, where the girl was given a wrinkled formaldehyde mink with pink skin, like a baby, but with a tail and two sharp teeth. Nothing was soft, its insides rubbery, and she wanted what was soft, oatmeal with cream for breakfast, the cotton threads of a gray sweatshirt that matched the morning sky. And they were told to cut the yellow fat of its body open, but also to respect the mink, its worm esophagus, threaded muscles, marble eyes. She took the bus home at 2:40 p.m., remembering the man framed in the window, the silent switching back and forth of skull, sidewalk, skull, the mink wrapped in plastic, its mouth hanging open. What tools she had laid on the scratched table, scalpel, scissors, hands, what is cut away and what remains? The girl closed her eyes, pushed herself against the bus's exoskeleton, went over again the systems, respiratory, circulatory, digestive, until she arrived home, peeled all that death off her shoulders. The girl ate dinner, because what was done was done. Nothing would bring the mink back, and the man was okay, or he wasn't. I still remember, I did not know what to do with that mink when I got home, and so I put it in the bathtub, because I figured that would probably be the best place for it. I mean, it's better than the kitchen, right? So I remember my mom walked into the bathroom and saw the mink. And of course, when you're in high school, you don't talk to your parents. So she had no idea what a plastic wrapped mink was doing in the bathtub.